Choice last year to end his relationship with any and all friends that he had among the Cali Allies. And one of the men that he betrayed is Golden Star. And Pentagono now is a member of a ruthless faction of hoodlums and Los Malditos, Benedito del Fortuno. Benny Azteca, Slayer, and added Pentagono to their group. Inside and outside, and then inside again by Golden Star to Pentagono, and Pentagono is slow to react, and Golden Star taking advantage early. And Golden Star is known for crazy high-risk offense, and he might be preparing to take flight right here. Oh no! That should be a disqualification right there! That can't be legal! He smacked that chair in a Golden Star's face as he was traversing from one side of the ring to the other. Oh, the momentum has ended. I can't believe the... Come on, ref, that can't be allowed. Oh, this is ridiculous. Somebody's got to stop this man. Los Malditos have gone too far. What a poor sport he is. He couldn't get the advantage on his own, so he had to swing a chair in his face. Oh, this is terrible. Running knee smash, bone on bone with the skull. And Pentagono smiling from ear to ear at the fact that he has pretty much totally placed this match in his own hands. Nobody is going to stop Pentagono in this ring. Dastardly flying elbow. Golden Star had only one direction to go, and that's down. And this could be it. I don't know how he bridged out. I'm surprised this match hasn't already ended. Well, it's supposed to be a six-man tag team match. It's now a singles bout. And it was a very fast-paced bout until that moment when Golden Star was about to dive, and Pentagono swung right at his skull, and Pentagono's gonna make Golden Star pay, apparently. And after the six-man tag team bouts in the past in December, it was bound to get violent. But I don't think anyone had a feeling that this rivalry would take a turn like it has. I wouldn't be surprised if Golden Star, his head might be entirely split open after having that head totally engulfed by that chair. I'm surprised he follows any of the referee's instructions after what he did moments ago in that chair. Watch out! Big back body drop. Golden Star is lifeless right here. What a sad situation. Everyone expected Golden Star to dominate, to fly all over the ring. And now Pentagono has robbed the fans, essentially, of having that moment, because now Pentagono is in a totally one-sided situation. And he gets the slam and destroy Golden Star from head to toe with slams, suplexes, drops, and strikes. Golden Star is hanging in by a thread, but his chances of even trying to fight back are almost zilch. He's got no partners. This is not a tag. He's against the odds, and Pentagono is at full strength right here. And I don't think Golden Star has any idea where he is. Look at that! And Sisters Takeover! And Golden Star's gonna try it again! Hit it! Fly body attack on a Pentagono on the far side! Golden Star's back to life! But he's probably still suffering. He probably has a headache after what happened earlier. But somehow, some way, he's trying everything in his, as a last resort to put Pentagonal away right here. Golden Stars second in the ring. Pentagonal waiting. Apparently he was trying to sucker him in. And there is the snapping arm drag. Golden Star answers. Back and forth they go. Both men collide. Double clothesline. And they're both down. A roller coaster of emotions in this matchup. Everyone thought that Los Malditos was a dominant faction that couldn't be stopped. But Golden Star refuses to be held down. He refuses to lose. He continues to fight on. He even invites him to get a head start. And he drop kicks the ankle right out from underneath him. Another drop kick there to the left arm and the left leg muscle. And then Pentagonal responds. Whoever can hit the other hardest may be the one to win. And Zaguri kicks and all. Lunging drop, and Pentagonal might be going for that big moonsault press at any moment. As he prepares to escalate the ropes, but Golden Star rolls in immediately. Wow, he mistimed it badly. He missed by a mile. Golden Star's gonna fly. He's going to the top, but jump! He missed his old Swanton Bob. What a miss! Neither man could score the advantage here. Pentagonal climbs, but Golden Star hits the uppercut. Golden Star joining Pentagonal along those ropes. Oh, this is a dangerous spot for both men. Nice hurricane rana. As Pentagonal was seated on the top rope in support, Golden Star, and the second time in a row, he misses that flying Swanton Bomb. And all of the wind has been knocked out of the lungs of Golden Star again. Pentagonal collides, tries to run backwards. Golden Star catches him. Crucifix, sit down, face planting, driver, and Golden Star's won it. What a come from behind victory for this man. The curse. They're the champions in this one, and it is sudden death, one fall. The first team to score the pinfall or a submission will win this match, and that knee smash just destroyed Billy Starr and already got a near fall. What a way to jumpstart the action. The two monsters of the ring, the curse, La Maldición, Los Reyes, the king of the worst and the bad. And they have plans on decimating their smaller adversaries. And there was a communication miscue the last time the N-Words got a shot at the tag team titles in an elimination match. And Navidad, they get another opportunity tonight. And they're not involved at all. And Billy Starr almost stole away the tag team titles instead. Guaranteed championship rematch for the tag title, but he's not teaming up with Storm Grayson. He's teaming up with Billy Starr, and another near fall. It's 2-on-1, McQueen alone against Beauty Arroyo and Billy Starr. Double team flapjack. They really put him down badly. And the snapping neck crank followed by this. Dropkick right to the face. Beardale Raw wants his tag team titles back. And with the rules being as it is, only two men have to be in the ring at any one time for any sort of pinfall or submission to happen. And now that the N-words are legal for the first time, Bryce Benjamin trying to take advantage on Beardale Raw. Nice springboard wristlock takeover by one of the top ranked in all of pro wrestling and Lucha Libre. Beardale Raw defends himself wisely, springboard forearm, and Dr. J with that crashing forearm in the back of the neck and head has knocked Beardale Raw to the outside. Billy Starr bounced the man right out of the ring. Billy Starr's got plans to take flight. Topiclaim over the top of the N-words on the floor. What's McQueen got plans on doing now? He's hopping on his feet. Is he going to take a chance? No, Beardale Raw stopped him before he was going to traverse between the ropes to the outside. Beardale Raw saves his partner. Tag team titles are on the line. The curse against two teams at once. Oh, dear. McQueen elevated Billy Starr and then Draconis with that fist to the face, and Billy Starr almost got wiped out right there. Tag team championships of Cali. When you think about the top teams in Cali in all of 2016, it was the Furious, the Prophecy, all the now the N-words, and the curse, La Maldición, Los Reyes del Mal. And with that being said, it's like the best of the best, but Furious Raw has found a new partner in Billy Starr. And Billy Starr with unsettled business with the Revolution, Scott A. Jr. He was kicked out of the group when he and Scott A. Jr. could not win the tag titles from Las Furias at Galley Mania or the Galley Anniversary Show. I can't quite recall. Pretty sure it was the Anniversary Show. Billy Starr with love to retain his mask and to be called Bandolero again. But the stipulations were clear. He no longer is wearing a mask and he wants revenge on Scott A. Jr. in the worst way possible, but he's not going to get that tonight. He gets a shot at being a tag team champion tonight. And Billy Starr and Scott A. Jr. previously have a victory against the curse, La Maldición. So it's very potentially possible that Billy Starr with this new tag team partner, Beardale Raw, could win the tag team titles for the first time as an alliance here tonight. Benjamin and Jazz want to win the tag team titles back, but they have not been as successful as a tag team without James Russo. Big splash to the back of Billy Starr. 6 feet, 5 inches tall, 220 pounds, just squashed the lower back and the spine of Billy Starr badly. And it's not looking good right here. The curse of Maldición, Los Reyes del Mal. They're really trying to smother Billy Starr in that corner. And there's too much size, too much power from these monsters. The kings of the most evil of the Rudos. I think the only trouble they had last year was when they were in odds with each other. And what a nasty thwarting attack, that crossing chop to the throat put Billy Starr down instantly. Referee's doing anything he can to slow down the progression of the N-words from getting into this match illegally. But for all technical purposes, they're doing damage to one of the other tag teams, and that's probably in their best interest. Let Los Reyes del Mal hurt themselves, or maybe take more gas out of the tank so that they can try to be the better opportunists in this tag team bout and intervene at exactly the right moment where they have the best chance to win. But when is that opportunity, and can it be now? That's another story. Billy Starr yanked down by his collarbone right onto the back of his head and neck. And misses as the Fire Lord Draconis almost scored the win right there for his team. Tag team title match. Action getting very physical in this ring. We wouldn't expect anything less from the curse in this battle. McQueen runs in and attacks with a big splash. Willie Starr leapfrogs over Draconis. He might have stung himself in the corner. Billy Starr, the fly body attack to Draconis onto the near side of the floor. Inward, double team spinebuster. But they have lost track of yet another body in this match. Furion Roa encountered elbow to Chaz, I believe. And Bryce eats the spear by Furion Roa. And Chaz gets wiped out as well. Big pickup in the air, Fireman's Carry. There's the neckbreaker. He's used that to win the titles before. But the N-words roll the outside. The Fire Lord Draconis suffered the fall on the outside. Could this be an upset right here? Billy Starr, there's the moonsault. New champions. No, McQueen in too close. Breaks it up. McQueen immediately shrugs and thwarts off the attack of Furion Roa, sending him crashing back first against that first turnbuckle pad on the far side. Billy Starr with a cross body block got caught. Swinging attack, Billy Starr's foot just collided into Furion Roa. McQueen's on top, and that's it. Los Reyes del Mal have retained the tag team titles.
Escuela de Lucha Libre Gali, para que cumplas tu sueño, visítanos 270 Weston Avenue en Villa Park, en la Arena Gali. Periódico Nueva Semana, cada semana busca los eventos de Gali a todo color, el periódico oficial de la lucha libre en Chicago. TBS, la cadena televisiva de Gali Lucha Libre. Ochoa y Asociados, para tus incontacts personales o de tu negocio te lo recomendamos, es el contador oficial de Gali. Si tienes mal crédito, es tiempo de repararlo, levantar ese puntaje y ser dueño de tu propia casa. Llama para reparaciones de tu crédito. Consulta completamente gratis. Five Star Swap Mart, casa de la Arena Gali, con muchos especiales todo el año. City Art Construction te da inspecciones de tu casa para que no pagues nada. Te podemos reparar tu techo y tu siding. Peleamos con tu seguridad sin que a ti te cueste nada. Tequila 5 Blancos, la más alta calidad sin el alto precio. La tequila oficial de la lucha libre.